September the 11th should say to the American people that we're now a battlefield.
George Bush's war on terror has put the nuclear agenda aggressively back on the map. And at 64, having lost her marriage and sacrificed her medical career in her bid to save the planet, my Aunt Helen's back with a fifth book, The New Nuclear Danger, determined to wage her battle all over again. I've marched against America's wars over the decades and it hasn't changed a thing. Does mass protest work anymore? Has the so-called left lost its way? And can an 80s-era dissident like my aunt really make a difference in George Bush's land of the free?
Oh, it always works. Especially when you're a physician, you have absolute credibility, and I talk about the medical consequences of nuclear war. And it's the same, whether it was described in the 80s or now.
U.S. forces give a nod. By your country.
It's hard to envision more terror on America than September the 11th.
Bombs and trenches all in row.
We did nothing to provoke that terrorist attack. It came upon us because there's an enemy which hates America. They hate what we stand for. We love freedom and we're not changing. We're at war.
Have you ever heard of Dr. Helen Caldicott?
Nope, never heard of her.
The who?
I heard people talk about her.
She's trying to stop George Bush.
I felt really strange flying into New York today.
Certainly the Bush administration has used September 11th brilliantly to enact all their laws and to start to destroy your constitution and your civil rights. And there's no one with the guts in the world to stand up to this country. It's the greatest country the world's ever seen, most powerful. But now they say we're going to drop nuclear weapons anywhere if we feel like it. Not just on a nuclear country, we'll drop them anywhere. It's insanity.
Americans did not want to hear what she had to say post 9/11. And that was a time of enforced patriotism, mandatory patriotism. And you told that line or you were shunned by the world. And Helen was not towing that line. And in effect, her book was shunned by the world.
Your book is titled The New Nuclear Danger. The Cold War is over, Helen. What are you worrying about? The Cold War is over. Tell me why it's worse.
The Cold War is not over. The weapons are still in place in Russia and America, 2,500 on hair trigger alert on either side, ready to go with the press of the button. That's what this war means.
With war looking all but inevitable,
there was a sense today of resignation that no matter what the protesters say or how loud they say it, the march to war cannot be stopped.
Extraordinary day.
Why?
In the history of the world.
That's a bit extreme.
No, it's not extreme, Anna. Because the Iraqi situation could induce a global nuclear war and we're all dead. God almighty.
That's where you lose the media, when you say that stuff.
Fuck it, Anna. It's the truth, and why don't you listen to me? Yeah, you're getting this on camera.
No, I don't want to use it. I don't want to.
Bugger it. You don't believe me.
I believe you.
No, you don't.
There.
But why don't you believe me?
That's why the media don't listen to you, because you say it's the Cold War.
Yes, and it is.
And it's old words.
It is the Cold War, only it's hot, and it could happen tonight. I'm talking about the end of creation, which I have been talking about since I read On the Beach when I was 15. That's what's hard to take in, and people don't want to hear it. Give me a pill. Give me something to block me out. Give us a drink. Turn her off. She's an idiot. Okay? So am I mad? Or is the media mad? Who's mad?
Maybe I can feel happy about what I've done if in fact we'd been successful, but we haven't. We've gone backwards 30 years with this Bush people. 30 years? No. Am I resentful? Big time. And you know, I'll probably die and you won't have got rid of the weapons and my life will have been in vain. I don't like that feeling because I like to be successful. I like to fix things. I like to cure things.